Good evening and welcome back. So, what are we doing today? Think I will start working on the compass. And it will not be a UI thing. That's not really what I want there. Scrolly text here. Okay. So, let's see when we open up the player here. We have those two. So the use compass and use map. I already have the custom stuff here, but I still need to add the input. Let's do that. Settings. Project settings and input action mappings. Okay, it's already here. Created those sometime last week. Okay. What we then need to do is, I think I need to create a blueprint for that so that the compass is, which I'm not sure. I think I will just block it out today. And then build the compass at another time. So here, create a new folder. And this would be think it's an actor. Quite sure if that's correct. We might change this at another time. So that's the compass actor. Add a component here. Let's just start with a simple plane. use. And let's change the name here. This would be the needle. Also just a static mesh, so it's okay. This can be static. This needs to move around. Let's see. Let's go to the event here. And I think for the moment, I think I will just use the event tick. Set relative rotation. So we need reference to the North Pole here. So let's call this North Pole vector ref. Now this can just be simple transform. Oh, let's get an actor, reference here. And then, okay, this we need to expose. So I want to set that in the editor. Then we get this here. Look at stuff there, so let's see. Thing. Ah, okay. So let's recombine those and throw this. So the start would be the needle. Get fault location. Okay, I want to change one thing here because I don't need the complete rotation to that. Just need the split that. Okay, how do we do this? So if we press that, ask. Spawn actor from class. And this is the compass actor. Okay, we need the spawn transform. I think I need to collapse this. First thing is we get the get actor transform for our character, and then hello. Something to. Okay, I can't add. Interesting. Location. Get forward vector. Scene component. So this no. The forward vector would only be 1 or 100 or something like that, right? So I can just multiply that by something to get specific distance. Let's try that. And we need reference to the North Pole. And we also need reference to this. Not promoter variable. Oh no, that's correct. So that's the compass actor. Reference here. Valid check. If that is not valid, then we do this. Otherwise, I'm not quite sure what I would do then. Let's just try that. So we need to set up the North Pole actor. Okay, so we need to get this, maybe. Or maybe the arrow component, not quite sure. Okay, so let's set an empty actor needs to be north, so it needs to be somewhere here. So that's the North Pole actor and the okay, so we need to set this somewhere. Problem is, let's try this and see if it works. So, get find. Wouldn't they have find all actors by class or by something like that? Problem is that the player, the first person character, is not in the scene. Because I'm just spawning it in on begin play. So I need to find the reference to that actor somehow. I mean, what I could do. Spawn that as well. Yeah, let's spawn that. Let's copy that number. And so here. What did I do? Class. Okay, so this is by class. Yeah, I mean it doesn't matter. We can just should be able to set this as an actor. else. Set our nose projector here. That way we have it in every map. At least in every, yeah, we would spawn the first person character new in every map, so it's okay. I think it works that way. Let's just try it and see what happens. Just land here somewhere and then play. And every time the same issue. Yes, I know. I just need to refresh it and compile. I really don't understand that error. But I have to do it. Every time I restart the editor. So. Oh, okay, so small issue. I mean, I can. Okay, it is already valid, but it's not moving with the character. So we need to change that. I think it needs to be a component. It needs to be an actor component and then add it to the character. So we need to change this. Nope, not what I wanted. Nope, nope, nope. I don't want to change anything on actor. Definitely not. Class settings. So that doesn't work that way. So I think I need to recreate this, even though there's not much in here. So it should be fine. So let's close that. And we need to create an actor component. Yeah. No, this doesn't work as a component. I mean, okay, I can try something here. So on begin play. No, this doesn't work. Let's change something here. Let's just see if the thing itself works. So let's connect this here as well. So if that's valid. Now let's just remove this. So every time you click the button, we spawn this. So I'm throwing a lot of compass actors in the map just to see if the rotation is correct or if I need to change anything there. Quite sure I need to change things because it didn't look right on the first one. Yeah, I think I need to add a rotation to the needle object. So let's fly over here where we would spawn the thing. And just try it over here. Problem is that I'm not quite sure I'm in the right spot. does look as if there's at least a small rotation there. So let's go back here. Go to the viewport. And let's add a rotation to this. Up. Oh, this is already a parameter. Delete. Yeah, closed everything else. So here the compass, viewport, needle. Easier, we just know where we are at the moment. So let's print. The actor location here. not quite sure how this works. That seems to be pointing. Not quite sure, is it pointing at something or just is that just my imagination? I think I need to add what did I add here? Okay, edit. Oh, I added the rotation. I need to so this plus 90. Problem is that I need something else here. Do we have an arrow? I do have an arrow, but apparently it's quite small, which makes sense. Now I need to rotate that. Yeah. Okay, this is a problem because this is. Yeah, this arrow has its pivot in the tip, which is not good. Something was. Was it here? So do we have other arrows? Also not working. I mean, this could work. Let's just throw it there and see what we get. Okay, it is pointing into a direction slightly at least, so let's see if that. Now I need to figure out a way to add this to the character because this is. The problem is we can't see it moving when it's not. This is not really moving here. Let's set this to movable. This to movable. Okay, so if it's not valid, we spawn it. And then on event tick. Just throw this here. Compass actor. Let's try that. Not quite sure if that works, but so that didn't do anything. Did I change here? This copy. There we go. Okay, so go somewhere else here on the map. Should see a difference here when we are running ar along the spine. Pointing in that direction. I mean, it kind of works, but. Not quite sure if it's pointing in the right direction. There probably is a better way than to use kind of a proxy object. Quite sure this is pointing in the wrong direction. Should be pointing slightly to the left. Screw up and put it in the wrong spot. Where is that? Why can't we see the position of it? Strange. But there's something wrong in the compass actor because only the needle should change rotation. The rest of the plane should be. No, I'm trying to create a compass. I'm not doing a magic carpet. Good evening, by the way. Have I missed anyone? I did say hello, middle, right? Hello, if I missed it, sorry. No, it's supposed to be a compass with a needle pointing in the right direction. Maybe I need to set this to static. Only this should move. Quite sure. Oops. Yeah, completely in the wrong direction. Wrong location. Yeah, let's spawn up here. Maybe we can. Okay, that's the problem. The rest needs to be movable, otherwise it's staying in place. So this needs to be movable. This needs to be movable. Quite sure if it changes. That's the problem with my map in some cases. Let's try to stay on top here. Let's run around in an area we can walk. Let's see if we get that. So this is roughly pointing in the right direction. It happens if we follow the road. Definitely not pointing in the right direction. Pointing at. That's the big problem. Try to remove this because this is kind of unreliable. So let's try to change the location where this is pointing to. And let's see, so we have, let's take that and change this to, okay, let's do the autosave. Let's change this to world. So it is negative y. Positive y is this direction, and I want this to be north. See what it does when we put this at zero. Yeah, we are way too high. This takes. I mean, yeah, okay, it would take ages for us to fall down, but. Okay, so this is definitely not pointing in the right direction. Because zero is under this mountain here in the middle. That's what I was doing earlier, but it also wasn't reliable, because the problem is I'm not quite sure about the rotation that I need to set to this. I want this to rotate, but I'm not quite sure how I set this up properly so that it actually is rotating. Thought I could do it this way, but apparently not. Maybe I need to do the world rotation? Let's try world rotation here. Somewhere. Need to try something. I is my... Wait. Where's my big object? That should block the view down there. Must have deleted that at some point. I had a big box down there just to block everything. But okay. This is zero. Okay, zero is, yeah, like I said. Zero is just below the mountain. Because all this stuff here is in location zero, the origin. So if I run around the mountain, the needle should spin. Let's see if that works. And it's definitely not pointing in the right direction. Let's... I had the plus 90. Let's remove that. Let's try this again. Okay, it is moving. Ah, okay. I think when we're up here, we should see it quite clearly. Because it should spin around at some point. Yep. Now it's spinning slightly at least. Okay, this is working. And we are past it, so... Okay. So, that setup is working. Now I just need to figure out a better way for this. So let's put this to minus... What is it? 5 million? Thank you. add stuff to this. So, this is not pointing in the right direction. Let's see, can we add? Text renderer, yeah. Let's add this, but not to the needle, to the plane. Let's change the text to north and change the rotation. I think this should be north. If I look at that, this doesn't have a rotation, so this should be north, I think. Let's try that. Problem is that if we rotate this, everything rotates. Not just the needle. And I'm just saying that the needle should rotate in here. Only the needle is getting new rotation, but it's rotating everything. Quite sure why. No, here we're just setting the location, so this is staying in place in front of the character. There's no rotation here. I mean, okay, it points north, but it's not. It's not working the way I want it to. not here. So it's not part of that. Let's see if that works. Yep. Doesn't change a thing. I mean, it wouldn't do anything here. Yeah, okay. Ah, damn it. So it has nothing to do with that, it's just that it's always pointing in that direction. So it's something in here. I think it's this. You're getting the forward vector. But that shouldn't change the rotation of it. Good question. It's the capsule component, and this is getting the forward vector here. In world space. And I think this is also world space. I'm not 100% sure. Yeah, this, I think this is world location, so. And here, doing anything else. Yeah, I'm only using the location here. Basically doing the same. No, wait, I thought I had. Yeah, but I'm doing no rotation, so not quite sure. Mean, it could be this, but would be strange. Connect this here again. So it is actually pointing north. The idea for the whole thing at some point is that the character is holding the compass in his hand. And then the needle spins in the right direction, but I can't test that at the moment because my characters are quite sure this doesn't work. Yeah, no, this doesn't work. Because it's not movable. Set this to movable. This to static. No, this doesn't work. So this needs to be movable. This needs to be movable. This needs to be. No, the problem is they all need to be movable. As a result, it doesn't work. Not quite sure why it does the rotation. Really don't know why. This needs to be movable. Yeah. Maybe I need to have the plane take the employer rotation and the needle put, I need to put into the rotation. North this way, then I can just set this here. Set the rotation. Set it point north, and then kind of be done with it. But that's not what I want. Want this to move around a bit. Stuff like that, but I mean, okay, it could work that way. Because it's still pointing north. I mean, it would be a lot cheaper if it's just that and points north, but it wouldn't look that good. Let's try something. No. So that didn't work. Try something else. Okay, so that doesn't do anything.
Hey guys, Twizz here, and today I'm going to be showing.
Sorry about that. Okay. All the compasses I find tutorial-wise are UI. And I don't want my compass to be UI. And it's also kind of like this the Skyrim bar on top. That's not what I want. Yeah, this is what I want. Something like that. This. Compass. Oh, different targets. No, that's definitely not what I want. try something else here. Let's take the plane. Yeah, let's do this. So let's connect those. Let's set up that. But for the plane, I want to set something different. Set world rotation. This is what I want. So basically we need to create mesh around it that's not moving, and then the inside would be the needle either on top of kind of a ring with the different directions on it, or separated needle, ring, and those should point north, and the casing around it shouldn't move at all. Oh, should move with the character. Okay, now I need to figure out if I want to delete that, or destroy the actor, or if I just want to hide it. Let's see. So if it is already valid, and we are pressing that button, let's see. So if we use the compass out of the unitary or press the button, I basically want to do a flip-flop. First, I want to check if it's valid. And if that's the case, then Flip-flop. Yeah, flip-flop. Let's do this. So it doesn't exist first, so we A, we are showing it. Okay. Let's set this here. And here we are hiding it. Let's see. Maybe I should set this up properly. Then it might work. Check this. Okay. So that's the compass. Now I just need to make it prettier. Let's change the name here to K. pacing. Yeah, this is the needle. Text renderer. I might remove the text renderer, but for the moment, let's just keep it in there. Yeah, I only need to do this back here. I don't need to do the front part here. Yeah. Because it's doing the rotation on its own. So let's remove all this. Okay. Okay, that was easier than I thought. This should definitely help people who couldn't find the directions here from the innkeeper. So he told us that it's out of the town to the east past the barracks. then here we do have this sign. It points towards northwest. So should be able to find it from there. West to the room. Thank you. Do you remember when you watched last? Thank you. But it's still a long time, a long way to go. Yeah, okay, so I think the compass definitely helps finding this, even if you run somewhere. It's easy to follow the road, might not lead you in the right direction sometimes, but it's... definitely helps. Let's hide that, and then here we are. Awesome. Oh, okay. Oh, interesting. By the way, there is a way to play this game, at least an earlier version of it, on my Discord. So if you want to jump in and test it out, it's not optimized. That's one of the biggest issues at the moment, but I need to figure out what's causing all that, and then change a few things. But the problem at the moment is that I kind of killed my characters, and type an exclamation point Discord, then you get a link to my Discord. Oh, okay. Yeah, there's a cooldown, but there it is. And you find it under game builds on the Discord. Under game builds, if you scroll up a bit, then the last version that I have here is the Bond version, 007. I haven't created a new one because I killed my character meshes. Nice. Thank you. And any feedback would be nice on the Discord itself, like other people did, or here live on the stream. If you have something to complain about or you noticed something, then you can say it here. Or if it's something longer, then type it up in the Discord. Okay. But I mean, it's an alpha prototype, I would say. You should be able to play through the main quest, but there are a few performance issues and few things are not quite clear, maybe. So keep that in mind. And if it doesn't run for you, please also give feedback with your machine specs and what kind of issues you had. Could also help. So, I'm not quite sure if I want to jump in and create that thing now or what. Let's see, how much time do we have? Bit less than 2 hours. Yeah, why not? Let's jump into Blender and see what we can do there. Let's go here because we need the hands as a reference for size. This is way too big. No, I didn't. The trees are bought. Fences and all the tree stumps and the boards here, that's all board stuff. And I created the modular pieces for the houses in Blender and I fixed a few textures on this stuff which viewer gave me, and this one here as well. No, the player character is also something that I copied over from the old prototype, the old version in Unity, and I didn't create the character. It's kind of a base mesh placeholder character to work with. No, I haven't heard of that. Let's make it slightly smaller. Oh, yeah, I remember. You can just type in real world. Dimensions here. When I change the dimensions, oh, it does the scale there, but I can change that, so it's fine. Even though I need to start with something else, not a cube. I think I need to, yeah, let's do it different. Yeah, no, let's start with the cylinder here. Okay. Big do we want to have this? Let's see. Don't have a compass at hand, but how big is a compass usually? It's less than 10 centimeters, right? Here. See, let's make this. Six by six by two. Oh yeah, that looks about right. Yes. Thank you. And hope your game also goes well. What's the name? Maze Core? We'll have a look for that. What kind of game is that? Kind of game is Maze Core? Strange. Okay, for some reason it doesn't want to open the link here, so let's do it this way. Mechanics, shooting. Yeah, one or two. Slightly, yes. Interesting. Okay. Interesting. Okay. Yeah, we'll definitely have a look at that at some point. face. Ugh. No. Under that. That's horrible. about that. That. And for the moment, let's give it metal material. And here the casing. Okay, this needs to be a lot smaller. Let's see if this shows up correctly. Yeah, it does. Maybe it needs to be a bit bigger. Or maybe a bit closer to the character. Maybe that's all we need to fix here. So let's jump back here. And let's yeah, let's create another cylinder. What? Nope. Undo. Yeah, maybe I could have created something simpler, but oh, is it part of this? Its own object, isn't it? Oh no, this is part of the other one. Ouch. Undo that. This should be its own object. Okay. Now let's add. Cylinder. Let's change the dimensions here. This would be 4 centimeters high. Looks about right. Okay. This didn't work. Let's make this new. Let's create a cylinder to fix the. Let's see, how many do we need? 6. I think I will go with 8. 8 should be okay. Centimeters. Let's show the other thing. Oh no, this is too much. Let's make this 0.5. Triangle fan. Okay, let's try it with that one. Start. Hello. Let's add a few cuts. I'm modeling a compass needle. Or compass as whole. Just, I'm adding, might add a ring here with the directions. Okay. What kind of game are you making? Yeah, it's something the player will hold in his or her hand, and then the needle supposed to spin, show north. This is what it should look like at some point. Though this is a bit, I mean, the casing is already in there, but the needle and the rest is a bit big at the moment. So as a result, it's a bit far away. So you add this closer to the character so that you can definitely see it. And I might just, when I have my characters fixed, I might just add this to the hand socket. So it's lying in the hand, and then I need to add an animation, take it from the belt and hold it up to the face or so, so that you can see it. Kind of like Minecraft, but slightly better looking. This one. Think I would just duplicate this. Then remove every face that we don't need. Think you can do a lot of stuff with IK stuff, with the IK system. Should be able to do this. Grab balls and stuff like that. This will be, let's give this proper names. This will be the, let's call action. Ring. This is the needle. And thank you by the follow, by the way. By the follow. Oh, okay. So kind of like stick to the wall and then hang from that. Yeah, but I think you can do this with IK stuff as well. But I haven't done anything with IK calculations and stuff like that, so I really don't know what anything about that. So might not be able to help you there. So let's see, let's extract, let's export that. There was a live stream of physical animations and stuff like that from Unreal Engine, and I think that's something that they could look into. But I'm not quite sure if it helps you and what you want to do with your stuff. Let's go that way. And let's import all that stuff in here. Oh, multiplayer is always a bit problematic. I haven't done anything with multiplayer yet, so can't definitely help you there. Here, let's change the needle. Let's remove the text render. And let's duplicate that. And this is the direction. Directions here. Yeah. Let's have a look at that. Okay, it is there, but it's too far away. So let's change this here. Let's make this 25. Oh no, let's change this to today. Compass distance. And do the same here. Oh, I think I there, so I need to change that. This is up here. Yeah, it's a plus. Not plus, but multiply. And I think I also need to change something else here. Forward vector. Let's change the whole thing. Let's collapse that to macro. Calc compass location, so I can change it easier later. So once I have the proper sockets, I should be able to just set this there and then spawn it in the right location. And we also need to change this here. here I need to. No, let's just add this in here. Let's add. Meter up. Let's try that. Okay, see this there, but it's definitely in the wrong place. So maybe not plus this. Okay, the compass is there, but needs to be. I had before here, so let's try that. And then I need to go into the compass actor and fix a few things there. Let's wait a moment and see for the floating orbiting camera. Why is it over there? So this shouldn't be. Let's make this the root needle. Okay, this here is too small. Yeah, this is it's needs to be 0. This as well. Hello. Oh. Ah, okay. I know what's happening here. We have a problem here. No, it's not the tick event. Wait, where is it? Okay. Ah, okay. This is the problem. Yep. That's not no longer there, and we can't do this, so scene component, object reference, root component. Yeah, let's do this. This should maybe work. Yeah, I'm still streaming, so Discord was correct. Okay, but it's still putting it somewhere where it shouldn't be. So the forward vector is a different one for some reason. Why is that? Ah, okay. It's there. Good. Now I need to make it closer. So let's put this to it's a bit hard to see. Because it's lying on the ground, so... let's push this up. Okay, now it's too high. That's too far away at the moment, so let's move this closer. Let's try 50. Then I need to change a few materials so that we can see the needle. I mean, it's there, we can see it. We can move it a bit closer. Let's put this to 25. Might be a bit too close, but let's see. This is good. I'm not quite sure why we run backwards now, but oh yeah, this is too close. This is just in front of us and it's blocking us. I mean, we can change this to not block us at all. No collision. And the other thing is I need to change the... Let's use predefined materials here. Let's take this as our casing there, then the needle. Let's make this gold. And this. Problem is that I don't have proper UVs for this yet, so it's something I need to do. But there we go. And it doesn't work anymore. Why the hell does it work? Okay. Did work earlier. Why does it not work anymore? Damn it. Oh, yeah, I know. It's yeah, I kind of broke this thing here. Okay, let's add a scene route again. Compile that. Yeah, I think this should still work. Yep. Even though it doesn't point towards... It's not pointing in the right direction. That's correct. Yep. Nope, this is not correct. So I need the rotation. is not pointing in the right direction. Okay, so should be here. This should be north. Should be nice. Okay. Let's try that. This is not pointing north. And yeah, this is wrong. North should be this way. Oh, okay, I think I know what's happening. The So this is set this back. Let's not set this here because I think the item itself has a different rotation, so let's see if that works. Ah, okay. Yeah, now it works. Okay, now I just need to create proper UVs for that and then set the textures correctly. But I think I will do that either offline or tomorrow, because I need to stop for now. Even though I was a bit late today, I still need to stop now. So, I will be back tomorrow and then either show you what I did. You know, on it, tomorrow I have an appointment, so I might do the UVs and stuff like that tomorrow. But I still need to look at something else to do tomorrow because it wouldn't be that long to do that. So, yeah, but apart from that, see you tomorrow. I will tell you tomorrow what I'm doing, so can't decide that now. Need to look through the project a bit more for other stuff. So, see you then. Bye bye.